Remember what to do, friends. Now tell me right out loud. What are you supposed to do when you see the flash?
Duck and cover.
Fellow members of the United Nations Atomic Energy Commission and my fellow citizens of the world, we are here to make a choice between the quick and the dead. Behind the black portent of the new atomic age lies a hope which, seized upon with faith, can work our salvation. If we fail, then we have damned every man to be the slave of fear. Let us not deceive ourselves. We must elect world peace or world destruction. Science has torn from nature a secret so vast in its potentialities that our minds cower from the terror it creates.
Sklaven sein, schrie die demonstrierende Menge. Der Generalstreik wurde proklamiert. HO-Lokale wurden vernichtet und in Brand gesteckt. Vom Brandenburger Tor hatte man die rote Fahne heruntergeholt. Am Potsdamer Platz sind Panzer aufgefahren. Die Leipziger Straße wurde abgeriegelt. Hunderttausend Demonstranten stehen unter dem Feuer der Maschinengewehre. Sechzehn Tote und über 100 Verletzte. Das Kolumbushaus am Potsdamer Platz steht in Flammen. Es herrscht Ausnahmezustand in Ost-Berlin.
Germany marked the sixth anniversary of the 1953 uprising by East German workers against Red Rouge. West Berlin, overshadowed today by a new communist threat, honors the scores who died under Soviet guns. Relatives of the dead and survivors of the uprising are present for replaying ceremonies which were denounced by Red news agencies as impudent provocation and an attempt to disrupt the Geneva Conference. But to divided Germany, it was a moment of solemn remembrance. Gesture of solidarity with 17 million now under communist rule. As Mayor Willie Brandt laid his wreath, the memory was still fresh of the day of desperate and gallant courage when civilians with makeshift arms hurled themselves against cracked Red Army tanks and guns. A hopeless gesture that was eloquent testimony to the East's true regard for its Red masters. The memory was still fresh to Germany and to the Soviet as well. A warning that the will for freedom is not dead behind the Iron Curtain.
The refugees get out at many stations, but once in the western sector, they all converge on the huge refugee camp of Marienfelder in the West Berlin suburbs. Here they have their first taste of western queues and western bureaucracy. There are questions to be answered and forms to be filled in, who they are and why they've come here. Why did you come here?
While the life of in East Germany is no good, and I can say what I felt, and is no freedom.
Why did you come to Berlin?
In the year 1953, the Eastern Secret Service has been come to me to spy the other people.
To make you spy?
Yeah.
On other people, yes? Why did you come here?
The schoolmaster wanted to have my boy communist machen.
He wanted to make your boy a communist?
Yes.
Have you brought your boy with you?
Yes.
Now, how long can the East allow this host of people, already 2 million strong, to escape, to vote with their feet? On the other hand, can the West allow this exodus to stop?
Mm-hmm.